Hey, what's up, everyone? Welcome to another episode of the Venom Vlog, and I have more time. So apparently I didn't have to go into work till a little bit later than I thought, so I figured I'd record one more of these. And so I sat down and reread this issue, which is Spider-Man, The Arachnus Project, issue 6. And the reason why I'm just focusing on this one issue, because I can kind of summarize the earlier stuff, at least Venom's involvement in it, because it's not a lot. But basically I'm calling this episode Venom versus Carlton Drake. Because you know, we didn't get too much of that in the Lethal Protector storyline. We got a little bit of it, but not a ton of it. But in this one, you actually get Venom versus Carlton Drake when he, after Carlton Drake mutates into a giant arachnus creature. So that's pretty neat. And so, you know, during this whole storyline, Carlton Drake and the Life Foundation are really amping up their business. They have an underground facility, a lot like Umbrella from Resident Evil, which I always talk about. And they're doing these new experiments and experimenting with, you know, spiders and everything like that. And what ends up happening is Carlton Drake mutates into a giant arachnid creature, kind of like a, you know, an alien queen almost in a lot of ways. And so what happened in issue 2, when Spider-Man was trying to track all this down and figure out what's going on, and he's working with the jury, you know, like Bomb Blast and Firearm and all those characters. And Venom saw one of the battles with the Life Foundation and Spider-Man on the news and was like, okay, I got to go get involved. So he travels, you know, thousands of miles, basically, you know, from San Francisco over to where this is happening in New York or outside New York to help out and take it down. So when he shows up at the end of issue 5. So issue 6 starts off right away with him in there, and he's trying to push back past everyone to get to Carlton Drake. And they're like, you know, trying to stop him, and they're, you know, they're fighting him, and they're like, no, Drake is sealed in a room. We're going to get in there, but, you know, do this our way. And Spider-Man's trying to calm Eddie down, and it's just not happening. And the jury, who has, you know, they've hunted, you know, Venom down before and stuff, and even captured him thanks to Ben Reilly at one point, they're just like, no, we're not letting this freak go. He's a murderer. We're going to take him down. So everyone starts shooting at Venom. And it's really cool. The artwork by Andrew Wildman is really great. I think he did the Carnage Unleashed storyline. And even though I didn't like the writing on that storyline, I thought the art was really good on it. Andrew's a great artist. And I think he did the Spider-Man 2099 storylines, which we'll talk about with Venom coming up soon. But then Mike Lackey was the writer of this issue. And it's overall, I mean, he did this whole series, I think, and it's a pretty decent series. I mean, it's fun. It's hard to find anywhere, though. I don't think they ever collected it in a trade, at least not to my knowledge, or reprinted it. And I don't think it's available digitally either, not to my knowledge, on Comixology. So this one you would have to track online, like through Mile High Comics or through, you know, eBay or something like that. You would have to track this series online. That's what I had to do for this one. I bought this on eBay because I don't think I kept this series. I owned it at one point, all 6 issues, but I didn't keep it for whatever reason. So, or it got sold in the collection or something that I didn't see. So yeah, I never got to hang on to it. So I ordered one of these on eBay, and it was only like $2 or something. So it's, you know, it's easy to find. But so this pretty much this, most of this issue is the jury and Spider-Man fighting Venom, trying to get him to stop, and, you know, and he's out of control, and he just wants to kill. So they finally get a blast on him with Sonics and knock Venom down. And they get a good headshot on him. And then right when they do that, that's when Carlton Drake shows up as the creature, the arachnoid creature that he is. And yeah, he's really gross looking. He's just like, look how awesome, though. He's really great. He's big. Like I said, he kind of looks like an alien queen, but with like little horns and like shoulder pads kind of thing. Or it's like these like armored pieces that grow out of his shoulders. He's got multiple arms. He's, you know, 8 arms, like Spider, he's got the 6 arms and the 2 legs, and he's coming after these guys, and he's taking them down. It spits acid, like you'll see, so it's very, like, aliens-esque, and they're all just taking their shots at him, trying to take him down. They weaken Carlton Drake, but then they not, and once they knock him down and bury him under some rubble, they're like, all right, we got to get out of here, you know, or we wait for him to get out, we get the kill shot, and Spider-Man's like, whatever you got to do, just help me get Venom up. And they even draw Venom with like a little pool of blood behind him. So that headshot got into Eddie a little bit, and I think it hit him in the head and got, you know, caused some blood to come out. So, but Spider-Man's like, no, we got to save Eddie. There's fire around. He's kind of weakened right now. And they're like, no, we're not going to help you save this murderer. Like, if you want to get out of here, Spider-Man, go. But Venom stays. He's going to burn alive down here, and we're going to kill this giant arachnid Carlton Drake monster. And they're like, you know, and Spider-Man's like, no, that's not going to happen. And then Venom wakes up. And he's like, oh, that's what's going to happen, little twerp. You think you're going to just take me down? So, yeah, there's a Mortal Kombat 2 ad. So that shows you how older this book is. It's 94, I think, for this one. Right when Mortal Kombat 2 was coming out to home consoles, I think, not to the arcade. But, yeah, anyway, so that aside, you have Venom here, and he's fighting back. And then when the creature wakes up, him and Venom go at it. And it's pretty much just a couple pages of Venom and Carlton Drake just, you know, slugging it out and beating each other's brains in. And then after that, they get separated. They fall down a hole. They get separated from the group. Spider-Man tells the jury to leave. He's going to go after Venom. they do that, but then Screech or one of the guys, he comes after Spider-Man. He's like, "Look, I learned from you today. I don't want to kill now, and you're right. We can be better. So let's go try to save Venom, his worthless hide. Let's go save him, and let's see if we can transform, Drake back to human form." And so that's what Spider-Man wants to do. So they go down there after him, but Venom is already in the middle of the battle. And Venom gets a good shot in and knocks Drake down into the fire down below and seemingly kills him. And then when Spider-Man thinks Venom's gone too, he looks up and sees Venom escaping on the other side. He's like, "Brock, wait." And Eddie's like, "Look, my hero part here is done. You get out of here. I'm going my way. We're going to continue our deal. I'm going back to home to San Francisco. You just stay out of my way, and we'll just re, you know, we'll honor our deal with each other." So Spider-Man's like, "Fine, okay." So, Venom departs and he grabs the jury guy and they bolt out of there. And when they get out, they make it to a door they can't get out of. It's, sealed, and they're like, "All right, we're gonna die down here. We're gonna die down here." So then what ends up happening is this guy, the main guy, I think this is the Screech guy, or at least Spider-Man called him that. His name's Hotshot, maybe. Or I don't know, maybe because every time Spider-Man talks to him, I can't tell if he's using a nickname or whatever. But I, you know, so maybe one of you guys can correct me. I thought it was Solo at first, but it's not. But he runs into the room and activates all the traps to cause he gets shot and wounded, but it unlocks all the doors or whatever somehow. And so the team, they get together, they form, and then this lady comes up, activates the final panel, and they're able to escape using the key card and stuff. So once they get out, they are saved. The place explodes just in time, like Resident Evil style. They all get out, they take an elevator up, they take a set of stairs, and they get out just as the place explodes. And yeah, so that's kind of where the book ends for the most part. Roland is there, Roland Treese, and he's like hanging out, and they're worried, like, what happened to our facility? We got to regroup, we got to figure out a new place to go forward with our business. And meanwhile, Spider-Man's with the authorities and everyone and the jury, and they're all kind of licking their wounds and talking to each other. And Spider-Man's saying how proud he is of the main guy. He's like, "Are you going to continue to be part of the jury? Are you going to continue to hunt Venom?" And the guy's like, "Yeah, maybe we will. I don't know. But we're not going to follow General Taylor's rules anymore." That was kind of the guy who lost, I think, the son at the vault, which we'll talk about coming up. But now they're, like, "Yeah, maybe we'll go our own route. We'll see." So this kind of leaves their story a little open-ended, which is kind of nice. But then little does he know is that Carlton Drake actually comes out reborn out of the ground after everyone has left, and after all the police and everyone have left, and he digs himself out and he's back to his human form, but he's rejuvenated, kind of it's a little bit more powerful, still has the power of that creature that he was, but now in human form. So it's kind of neat. So I like that it left his story open too, and I think they do go back and cover him a little bit because I don't think he's still alive in the comics. I think he did die in another series. So I'll look that up, and we'll get into that series. If one of you guys know what it is, you can let me know down below, and I'll try to track down those issues. And we'll talk about them in the coming future. But Carlton Drake, obviously, he was the villain in the first Venom movie. And then the first Venom movie, he became Riot. So it kind of made sense because in the comics, like I said, he does become this arachnid creature. And instead of doing that for the movie, they just gave him a symbiote. So it was still kind of, in a way, comic accurate of him turning into something else and then fighting Venom, because that's what happened in this series here. And then there was like a facility going on, explosions and a fire that Venom knocked him into. And that's kind of what happened in the movie as well. I think he put him up in the ship or something. The ship blew up. But yeah, it was pretty neat. So this book, I don't know, brought back some memories. It's not a super great series in my opinion, but it told a pretty neat storyline, and like I said, has a kind of a good ending for Spider-Man, in a Spider-Man kind of way, to where he kind of feels bad about the bad guy going away, but also still helped all the good people that were involved. And then you got a little bit of closure with Venom and Carlton Drake and the Life Foundation in this one. But it does pick up, I think, later on in another book. So we'll track that down and find out what that is. And we'll talk about that in the near future. But if you read this book yourself, or if you haven't and you have questions, let me know down in the comments below, and we'll continue our conversation down there. Thanks so much for watching my show. As always, like, share, subscribe, all that fun stuff. And I'll see you in the future. Peace.